Hi, and welcome to the second and very short video about LangChain, in which I want to talk you about choosing the right large language model for the task you want to perform. In the previous video, and I strongly suggest you look at that video, I've created an agent with a zero-shot React. So I'm using the React framework. And I've configured it to use GPT 3.5 as the underlying large language model to perform the orchestration. The problem was that it correctly determined that we need to extract the audio from the video file. We need to call the OpenAI Whisper plugin to extract the transcript timeline. But in the third step, when you just need to determine that the second step produce the transcription, it returned to the agent the correct information you need to call the third plugin, the summarization plugin. But as input parameter, it simply tells the agent, you just need the output of the previous plugin. So it actually called the large language model, the plugin, with the text, the previous, the timeline extracted from the previous task. Now, this happens because GPT 3.5 has less capability than GPT And actually, the kind of interaction was perfectly good if from the other part of the large language model, there would be a human and not an agent. Because if from the other part, there would be a human understood that it simply need to copy all the transcription output of the second plugin and to pass to the third plugin, not the string, the previous output. So this is the power of LangChain. You can choose the large language model to use. So just retry the very same chain, this time configuring GPT-4 as the large language model to orchestrate the agent. Now, in this interaction, we can see that the situation is different. This time, in the last step of the React framework, the thought is, now that I have the full transcription, I can summarize. It correctly, as the previous example, GPT-4 correctly determined that the summarize timeline plugin must be called, but this time as action input, it will include all the output of the second plugin, because the agent that works with the React framework, the zero shot, is really simple. It just continue to use React framework and parse the output of the large language model, simply telling the action is a summarized timeline and the action input, and it takes the string. It does not interpret the string in any different way. So we need the model, the large language model that orchestrates the React framework to be correct and correctly use all the output of the previous plugin into as input of the third plugin. This is a controversial situation, and usually 3.5, GPT 3.5 is usually enough. But in this situation, the problem is that the output of the second plugin is a really long piece of text because it's the full transcription of an audio of a video. So since the output is so long, the large language model, GPT 3.5 especially, tend to just save output in the prompt, simply telling you, hey, you need to call the right plugin, but simply use the output of the previous plugin. I don't want to repeat everything to create a super long prompt. GPT-4 is a little bit more smart, if we pass me the term, and being more smart, it understands that it indeed need to specify the complete parameter, and so it output the whole transcription, making a correct call to the third plugin. And now the latest observation is correct. I have a summarized timeline. And so the final thought is, I now know the final answer, and it gives me the final answer. And in this time, as it happened with the semantic kernel example, actually the result is not what I really want, because what I really want was the output of the third plugin. So in the last call to the large language model, it still manipulates the output, and it's actually creating a compressed timeline, but it does not report my full timeline. But having verbose through, I can really copy and paste paste the text anywhere else. But nevertheless, this video allowed me to show how important it is to select the right large language model to drive the orchestration of your agent. And this concludes this video. I hope you liked it and see you on the next one. Bye-bye.